Joining us is the author of the Down with Tyranny blog and also the founder and treasurer of the Blue America PAC, which raises cash for progressive candidates, Howie Klein. Thanks for joining us again, Howie.
Thanks for having me.
Well, ENDA passed the Senate last week. It would end discrimination of LGBT employees in the workplace. It's still legal in close to 33 states to fire somebody because they're gay or not hire somebody because they're gay. And it passed in the Senate. We have yet to see what's going to happen in the House. Lindsey Graham, a Republican from South Carolina, who's running for reelection, how did he vote on ENDA?
He voted against ENDA, as did Mitch McConnell. So the two most prominent closeted Republicans in the Senate both voted no, which was pretty shocking.
When you say closeted Republicans, you mean they're ashamed of being Republicans?
No, they're proud of being Republicans. They're ashamed of being gay, and they try to hide that from their constituents. Lindsey Graham doesn't really try to hide it from his colleagues in Washington. Everyone knows he's gay, but he definitely hides it from the voters back in South Carolina. So he's sort of like more like the Mark Foley kind of character. Foley was pretty much out when he was in Washington. He was prancing around and sort of having a bit of a gay lifestyle. Everyone knew he had boyfriends and stuff like that in Washington. But back in Florida, where he was a congressman, no one knew. You know, back in the churches of his district, people had no idea that he was gay. And Lindsey Graham is like that. He tries his hardest to hide it from his own constituents while, you know, being pretty much semi-open in Washington. McConnell is much, much more uptight, and his closet door is closed much, much more tightly.
I didn't know about Lindsey Graham until you told me. And again, it doesn't matter what somebody's sexual proclivities are, unless you're a queer basher. And by voting against ENDA, Lindsey Graham's sexuality is very much relevant. One of the problems with American politics is you can pretty much say anything you want about a politician, and they can't sue you for libel or slander. If Mitch McConnell, with his movie star looks, he could easily be out here in Hollywood. If Mitch McConnell were, say, a matinee idol, would you make the same charge that Mitch McConnell is gay, knowing that he could sue you?
Well, there wouldn't be any reason if he were, you know, the reason to let people know about Mitch McConnell's sexuality is because he's fighting against equality for gay people. If he were a private citizen, there'd be no reason to talk about his private life. Now, whether he's actually a practicing homosexual or not, I don't know. I don't know if he is. He was at one time. He was kicked out of the Army after 2 weeks for
Larry Craig behavior?
Well, just say molesting, and he was an officer, he was molesting an enlisted man, and he got thrown out of the Army. And his records are not available for anyone to look at. But there have been several people who were there at the hearing when he got kicked out who have talked about it. Although none of them want to go on TV and talk about it, they have discussed it. And McConnell is, he's very secretive and quiet about it.
He's also running for re-election in Kentucky.
And he has two opponents. He has a Tea Party opponent, Matt Bevin, and he has a very strong conservative Democratic woman who's running against him. It was funny because, you know, she's an NRA person. He makes believe he's, this tough guy, and she challenged him to meet her on a shooting range for a shooting match, and he almost peed in his pants.
You're gay, and you know you're gay, and you vote against ENDA. How do you sleep at night when your head hits the pillow when their head hits the pillow to bite it? How do they? Is that offensive?
No.
Okay. When their when Lindsey Graham and Mitch McConnell's head hits the pillow at night and they bite on it, how do they sleep?
I'm always fascinated with that subject. And a lot of them will make excuses for their past behavior. As a matter of fact, tomorrow evening I'm having dinner with one of them, an ex-Republican congressman who was out. He's sort of like Lindsey Graham. He was out while he was in Congress in Washington. Everyone knew he was in Washington, he was gay. But in his own district, it was verboten to talk about. Nobody would ever talk about it. He was friends with the newspaper publishers, and it was not allowed to be ever mentioned in the newspapers that he was gay.
You're talking about Dennis Hastert.
I'm not.
The wrestling coach? I'm joking.
I'm not talking about Dennis Hastert. I'm talking about another one. I would normally just say who it is, but since I'm having dinner with him tomorrow evening, and he there's a chance he could hear this, I'd rather not make for an unpleasant an unpleasant dinner.